myself. My name is Rafiki. My appearance may be that of a baboon. I'm in reality a shaman, spiritual leader of all the pride men. I will be your guide this evening as we embark on the wonderful adventure of Simba, the future king. As you witnessed, the blessing of young Simba was an event that was attended by all the pride men animals. All that is, except for one noticeable absence. Scar. He is Mufasa, the current Lion King's brother. Scar's jealousy of his brother's role of king of the Pride Land has been the proverbial thorn in his side for years. Now that jealousy has turned into the next king of mine, Simba. Ha, Simba. Babies don't stay babies for long. No, no. Our young Simba has grown up into the spirited, restless little puppy. King Mufasa has carefully taught Simba the responsibility of his upcoming role as future king.
Everything you see exists together in a delicate balance. As king, you need to understand that balance and respect all the creatures, from the crawling ant to the leaping antelope. When we die, our bodies become the grass, and the antelope eat the grass. And so we are all connected in the great circle of life.
Did you hear Mufasa point out the boundaries of the pride land? The cows will be cows, and you know it. About curiosity. But someone will take advantage of that curiosity. Someone with a dark heart. Need I say the name? Scar. Scar is tricky on Simba into visiting the elephant graveyard, which Simba knows is outside of the pride land boundaries. Scar has plotted a nasty little surprise for the curious cub.
Yeah.
nasty surprise Star had done for him. With that surprise came in the form of Bunza, Shinzi, and Ed, three very hungry hyenas. The only thing that saved those two foolish cubs was Mufasa. Yes, that's right, King Mufasa. He arrived just in time to taught those three crazy hyenas a lesson. Poor, I'm sure they were hurting for some time after that. King Mufasa had another lesson to teach the young Simba. Simba had gone outside the Twilight boundaries and disobeyed him. King Mufasa told Simba that doing something foolish just to show bravery was wrong. Kind of father and son loved each other very much.
Simba, let me tell you something my father told me. Look at the stars. The great kings of the past look down on us from those stars. So, whenever you feel alone, just remember, those kings will always be there to guide you, and so will I.
king in his plan to remove anything in his path to become king. That meant Simba and King Mufasa. Scar's plan involved convincing young Simba he needed to work on his roar. He took Simba to Canyon to practice. Meanwhile, he and his hiding hyena started standing in the wildebeest. Simba was going to be crushed to death. Zazu managed to warn Mufasa that Simba was in mortal danger. King Mufasa arrived just in time and saved Simba, and he got him to safety. But in an attempt to reach safety himself, there was Scar. Scar for years let jealousy turn him from a majestic lion to a monster, and he committed the ultimate monstrous act. He killed his brother, Mufasa. He then convinced them that it was his own fault his father died, and to run away. He sent his hyenas after him to kill him. Unfortunately, they were not successful.
Yeah. Yeah.
Our young Simba has grown up and now must face his responsibilities. But facing those responsibilities means also facing Scar. Scar, as the new king of the frogland, he has not been a wise ruler. By allowing the hyenas to enter, the balance of life has become tilted. There isn't enough food for everyone. Simba and Nala, along with their friends Timon and Pumbaa, realize to restore the balance of life, they must return and fight.
Thank you. performances like this, and I think our actors and actresses did such a fine job tonight. Give him another hand. Thank you so much.